So we often hear about this idea of behavior problems or disruptive behavior, and that can sound very colloquial and sort of like, but every kid has disruptive behavior, and this is true. However, clinically, when we think about disruptive behavior disorders, we're thinking about these are the kids who are often argumentative, they talk back a lot, they have a really difficult time following rules or respecting authority or boundaries. These are the kids who are intentionally annoying other people or may even tend to blame other people when they misbehave. So many parents say, but these behaviors are really common for young kids, and that is true. These behaviors are typically developmentally normative in the preschool years, and it makes sense because in our toddlers, we're trying to figure out where are the boundaries in the world. So what happens when I push the limits? What happens when I say no? What happens if I throw my food on the floor? What happens if I push my brother or sister down? What's going to happen? And now I'm sort of learning about what the consequences are in the world around me. However, as children get older, sometimes those kind of lessons don't really stick. One thing we notice is if they're experiencing a lot of these difficulties or symptoms, it can start to get in their way of their ability to do things that they need to do, like go to school, successfully have friendships, be around other kids, engage in activities, and it can also especially have a really big negative impact on the caregiver-child relationship, because parents are just feeling that they're fighting every single battle trying to get their child to listen to them and to do what they want during the day. But there are many reasons, too, why kids experience disruptive behaviors. So when we're thinking about a straightforward disruptive behavior diagnosis, one that often comes to mind is oppositional defiant disorder, or ODD. So this is a disorder that's characterized by kids who have many of the symptoms that I described before. However, there may be other reasons why kids experience disruptive behavior. So for example, if a child is anxious, they may have a really difficult time managing their behavior and their irritability that comes actually out of their panic and worry. So a child, for example, who's scared of going to school, a parent says to them, it's time to put on your shoes and your socks to go out the door, and the child starts having a meltdown. That can look just like oppositional behavior. You're just fighting back, you're just saying no, and maybe it's actually driven by anxiety. Some other common diagnoses that we see that can drive difficulties in managing behavior problems are things like ADHD, right? So these are the kids who are kind of hyperactive, maybe inattentive, but have difficulty managing their impulsivity, and also things like learning disorders or sensory processing difficulties. So it really points to the importance of really careful screening and diagnosis to make sure that we carefully understand what's happening for a child, what might be driving disruptive behavior. Are there other things that are going on at the same time that are actually more primary and hence the trigger for the disruptive behavior? And what is a good treatment plan to put in place?